Starfleet Intelligence has learned more about Ambassador Bavat. Marta, the woman Starfleet rescued from the treasure trading station, claims that the Klingons have a secret base in the Hiromi cluster, and that they are using as a staging area for an attack on the Federation. I have been authorized to provide you with the coordinates of the Klingons' base. Proceed to the Briar Patch and find out what the Klingons are hiding. If there are any weapons there, you are to deactivate or destroy them.
You are so predictable. And like a Tarkalian sheep, you were blindly led to the slaughter. I knew you would find my weapon research station. I was the one who sent Marta to give Starfleet its location. While you were busy destroying what you thought to be all of our work, my crews were busy offloading the more promising weapons and data onto the ship that has a nice head start on you.
That was a close one. It's a testament to your academy training that you and your crew survived.
Congratulations, Commander.
There are more reports than usual about Klingon and Gorn attacks along the border of Federation space. Starfleet has created a task force to patrol the area. Proceed to your assigned coordinates in the Zarentine system and begin patrolling. If you receive any distress signals, you are authorized to do whatever is required to assist.
Let's go.
Good work. I'm looking forward to reviewing your report. On first glance, it's clear that the Klingons are doing something with genetic modification. Since they don't have their own equipment, they're stealing ours. This is a bad road, and I suspect there's worse news to come.
Congratulations, Commander.
We have reports of a True Way fleet entering the neutral zone and picking a fight with the Klingons near the Donatu system. Having two of our enemies fight is good for the Federation, but I want to know why the True Way is so far out of their territory. Intercept them and deal with them. If you need to engage the Klingons as well, do so. A Starfleet task force has already been sent to the area. You'll need to join them in the Donatu system as soon as possible. Until next time. Are you sure you found no sign of the Cardassians attempting to open a portal, or otherwise bring the Davidians into our phase variants? This is troublesome. There are pieces to the puzzle I don't have yet. Let me do some digging and I will be in touch. Until next time.
Congratulations, Commander.
Until next time.
Welcome to Josanna. You're cleared for docking. We have everything you need for shore leave. And a few things that you didn't even know you wanted. Shopping, drinking, dining, entertainment. You'll find it all here. And don't forget the 77th rule of acquisition. If you break it, I'll charge you for it.
Get your Comet Cocktails! 4.7% discount for the next 3 minutes! Welcome to Drosanna Station, the home of the finest libations and pleasures this side of Rix. Care to hear about today's specials? Have you tried the Comet Cocktail? It's out of this world! We've got everything a brave Starfleet officer like yourself could want. There's access to shopping, subspace message stations, a few quality vendors, drinks, dancing, and Dabo. That Lita hologram is really something. Makes me want to get a handful of her pixels, if you know what I mean. My partners and I took this place over a few months ago. It was an abandoned piece of space junk then, but with some hard work and careful financial planning, we will make it a pleasure destination to rival Ryza or Casperia Prime. Good deals and good times. You'll find it all on Drosanna Station. Humans, I think. But history has never been my thing. The present is where the latinum is. I know the station was built in the mid-23rd century and served as a trading post and supply station for colony ships and military vessels. Then the House of Duras owned it for a while, but they gave it up in the 2370s. It was empty until my partners and I arrived. Do you know we had to spend 3 weeks scrubbing bloodwine stains off the decks? Between that, the globfly infestation, and voles in the computer circuitry, it's a wonder that we ever opened our doors for business. Good deals and good time. Aren't we all? Me? I want a leggy Vulcan with a liberal attitude toward interspecies relations. So, are you looking for someone in particular, or just some company? Oh yeah, I know Samara. Maybe she's been here recently, and maybe she hasn't. My memory is kind of hazy. Yeah? You need to find Samara, and people on Rurapente need warm socks. Everybody has needs, my friend. Let me spell it out for you. Information like that isn't free. Have you tried the Comet Cocktail? Oh yeah, I know Samara. Yeah, I'm sure we can. In fact, I feel my memory clearing up already. I tell you what. I know you Starfleet types aren't big on Latin, but what you do have are skills and a willingness to get your hands dirty. That's what I need right now. Our replicators are on the fritz. Maybe it's the whole power system because lights are going wonky too. But a little blue mood lighting isn't as big a problem for me as unfilled drink orders. Go to the cargo bay and get my replicators working. By the time you're done, I'm sure I will have remembered where I last saw Zamara. Get your Comet Cocktails! 4.7% discount for the next 3 minutes! Welcome to Drosana Station! Have you tried the Comet Cocktail? It's out of this world! How should I know? I'm a bartender, not an engineer. The lights started going crazy a few days ago, which was terrible timing. We're getting more business than normal because of the Comet, and the last thing I need is a critical systems failure. The 193rd rule of acquisition says that trouble comes in threes. The lights, the replicators, what's next? Good deals and good times, you'll it's nothing. Old station, bad lighting. Maybe your eyes were playing tricks on you. How long has it been since you had a physical? But it's probably nothing. No, I'm sure it's nothing. Don't worry about them. market. Good deals and good they are, and I am exceedingly pleased by your generous offer to repair them for no compensation. I can't let you go away empty-handed, though. How about I give you a 15% discount on drinks and souvenirs for an amount of time to be determined by management? Fine. A deal's a deal, right? Never let it be said that I'll cheat a valued customer like yourself. Personally, I don't know why you're so interested in her. She's a looker, but just try talking to her. She's more paranoid than an Obsidian Order agent in a room full of Tal Shiar. Zamara usually hangs out near the Dabo tables. Keep an eye out for a looker wearing purple. You can't miss her.
Be careful. They're watching. I'm not in the mood for a chat right now, thanks. Shh. Keep your voice down. I'm being watched. I've seen too many familiar faces in the crowd, and there are shadows, watchers in the dark. I see them out of the corner of my eye when they think I'm not looking, but I'm always looking. When the lights change, there they are.
Oh, what's the harm in a little friendly
witch? Watch yourself. They're everywhere. You weren't sent to help me. You were sent to watch me. Drake needs me to keep feeding information to Starfleet Intelligence. The Klingons come here and they drink and they talk. It's amazing the bits of information you can pick up around a Dabo table. Everything, even the smallest detail, is important. Captain Gerard was in here last week. He ordered blood wine, an entire bottle of the 2309 vintage, to be exact. That business with the House of Torg must have upset him more than
before. Watch the wheel.
When Gerard's happy, he drinks Warnock. Watch yourself. They're everywhere. Torg was on the High Council until he made a play to destroy the House of Martok. He was partially successful. Mavan, son of Drex, is dead. The House has no heir unless Drex takes a new mate and fathers a new son. But Martok's widow is wise. Her son, Drex, was off fighting in the war, so Lady Sirella called in KDF officers to defend her house. They exposed Torg's treachery, and Jempok was forced to discommodate him. As to why that would make Gerard unhappy? Torg raised Gerard after his mother died. Now he's an outcast, and his house has fallen. Gerard cannot speak to him without losing his own honor. Watch yourself. They're everywhere. Find out who's watching me. I'm not safe here. The Klingons are looking for me. They know someone has been feeding intelligence to Starfleet. The ghosts are always watching. Their eyes are hungry. Yesterday, they surrounded a drunken Klingon.
Keep your eyes
on me. Now he's dead. They will find me when the blue light shines, and then I'll disappear. How could you know that? You may think you know. You may even have readings in your tricorder that you think are right, but you don't know. How could you know? I'm here every day. They watch me, and I watch them. No, they're everywhere. They're watching. You've been here too long. Someone will notice that we're together. Go do something else. Play Dabo. I'll contact you when I'm ready.
Oh,
when it's safe.
Your luck has to change.
Watch it.
Can't you see I'm busy losing all my ladnum? Can't you see I'm...
Spin the wheel and win. Close enough. I couldn't wait for you to get that lucky. We would have been here all night. Psst. Zamara wants me to give you a message. She wants you to know, if you're interested in finding out what's really going on here at Drazana Station, you need to check out the lower levels. I have an access code for you that will get you past the security doors. If you want to talk with her again, I suggest you collect your winnings and catch her before she leaves.
I'm not in the mood for a chat right now, thanks. You don't need to worry about me. I'm going to leave this place to the ghosts. They seem to belong here more than we do. I've booked passage on a ship. You don't need to know which one. Just tell Drake. He'll keep getting his intel, one way or another. Good luck. You're going to need it.
Welcome to Drazana.
Trading ships, making supply runs in the Bolian sector. It was exciting, but it was crazy too. I never knew where I was going to be, or if my parents were going to have enough latinum to keep the ship flying. Then there was that time with the Orion pirates, and let's just say it wasn't the best environment for a child. All I've ever wanted was stability. I used to envy the kids on the colony worlds we served. For a while, I even thought about becoming a farmer. I wanted to wake up at the same time every day, go to the same job every day, even eat the same food most days. I like working on a starbase. It has a little bit of unpredictability, but every night my quarters are there waiting for me, and they're always in the same place. Good luck, and stay safe. I have had dealings with him in the past. I think he's some sort of military strategist. He visits here from time to time, although Commander Wildman is never too thrilled to see him. He's always treated me well, though, so I don't have any reason to dislike him. Good luck, and stay safe. Mostly he wants updates on our research projects. Last week he was asking me all sorts of questions about the Synchronic Distortion Prototype Rifle. We work with prototypes of new equipment here. I'll bang on something for months to find out all of its advantages and problems before it's sent into the field to be used by Starfleet. Even then, it takes years or more testing and iteration before something becomes standard fleet issue. And most equipment never makes it that far. There are hundreds of inventions that just don't work, or they don't work the way we want them to. Those failures are then broken down and their components are recycled. We have to keep everything secure. If the Romulans or the Klingons got their hands on what we are working on here, they could learn a lot about our technology. Good luck, and stay safe. That was a complete disaster. The basic design came out of Memory Alpha, and it was intended to detect and damage cloaked opponents. Someone there got an idea that the Romulans were developing personal cloaking devices, even though the power needs of something like that would be incredible. I recommended against sending it to field testing, but it went anyway. The crew on the USS DeWitt had some luck in modifying one for use as a hand weapon, but their prototype was destroyed when the ship was lost in the neutral zone. I hadn't thought about it again until Drake asked about it. Good luck, and stay safe. So that explains why Drake was interested in the prototype. It was a complete failure at detecting polarization cloaks. But if I added a phase modulator and reversed the polarity, these modifications should be no problem. And when I'm done, this beam will pack quite a punch against phase-shifted Davidians. I'll forward the weapon on to Drake as soon as I'm done. Be careful. The Davidians won't stop. I'm afraid we'll have to be ready to fight. Good luck.
Good work. Zamara may think she has slipped my noose, but I always have ways of keeping tabs on her. I take special care to know all about people. But you already know that, don't you? The ghosts that Zamara mentioned concern me, however. You already encountered Davidians once. It's likely they're on Drazana Station as well. And I won't let them use Federation citizens as food. Lieutenant Kalapo has completed work on the Synchronic Distortion Prototype Rifle. It should help you when you're ready to enter the lower levels of Drazana. Drake out. Until next time.
Congratulations, Commander.